Hey, what's up?
Not much. I'm just burning a leaf here.
Well, guess what? Guess what I just found out.
What?
I think we both might be dragons.
Really?
Yeah. Isn't that awesome?
Yeah, it is.
Like the video and subscribe.
Hello there and welcome. My name is Sparckman and today I want to do a quick example on Fruit Ninja. Alright, yeah, let me just show you this example. Here are some random watermelons and you can slice them by doing this. This works great for mobile games. Okay, so let's build it. Alright, so let's open the example file, which you will find under the description below. And let's have a look at this example. Now, if you run this, you'll notice that watermelons begin to pop out from the bottom. And you can't slice them. Let's go to the event editor. And you notice that this is only like 3 events. And what we're doing here is that every second we're creating the watermelons at the bottom. We're applying physics impulse of 400. And this is the angle I'm using, 80 to 100. Let me show you quickly. Okay, so this is why I'm using 180. The watermelons are going to shoot in any of these directions. And whenever the watermelons fly with this green object, they get destroyed if you don't destroy them. Now, the watermelons are physics objects. They're just static objects. This is the settings I'm using. For the physics engine, if you double click on it, you can see that I'm using a 15 for gravity strength. And everything else is pretty much the same. Now, these two objects here, for when you cut the watermelon, this one here is a pinball object. The initial directions for the bottom part are a little different. They're about the same, but now this here is just an active object. It's nothing. This is a static object. And finally, the background, that's just the background. Alright, so let's begin. I'm going to select the this active object here, and let's go to variables or values. Let's create a new value. Let's call this a life. Let's go to the event editor, and let's create a condition with the mouse. Repeat while mouse is being pressed. Okay, if that happens, we create more of these active objects. It doesn't matter where. And we're going to set the x coordinate of the object equals the x coordinate of the mouse. Same goes for the y position. We're going to do the same thing. The y equals the y position of the mouse. Give you something like this. Let's create another condition every 1 millisecond. We're going to add one to life. Okay, which is the variable we declared earlier. And if you run this, you notice that nothing happens. All right, so in the same line, let's go to scale. Let's set scale. Get scale. Equals the x scale of the object minus 0.1. Maybe let's try, 1 is fine for now. And if you run this, you're going to get something similar to this. Now to save memory, we want to destroy the object. So if the object's life is greater than 25, then we simply destroy it. Maybe we should make this a bit longer. Going to 0.5, so it would be like 0.05. Yeah, that seems a little better. Alright, so for the collision, let's create a collision between the watermelon and the blue object. So if that happens, we destroy the watermelon. Let's try it out. You can see that works. Let's filter this a little bit. The life of the block needs to be lower than 2, maybe 1, maybe 3. Let's try it out. So that way you can't kill the watermelons with the tail. Now when you destroy the watermelons, we want to create a top part from the watermelon, and we want to also create a bottom part from the watermelon. Try it out. You can see that this works not too bad. Let's add a sound to this. That's a little too much. That's for like a bonus sound, I guess. But this one sounds not too bad. Now I only have one object, but you can add as many as you like. And yeah, this works great for cell phones and tablets. Alright guys, thanks for watching, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, follow me on Twitter, like the video, and I will see you in the next... Hello! And I will see you in the next episode. Like the video and subscribe.